disco inferno.
She had a bun in.
Wait a minute. What's it say on that piece of paper? She just brought a piece of paper. What does it say?
You're in trouble.
What? Quick roll up. It's two and only a two count, and there she goes. Miss Hancock headed to the back. Saving possibly the tag team belt. Quick roll up now by Lane on Big Vito, and Johnny the Bull was there to make the save.
Well, you have to do what you have to do in a match like this. It's for the goal, it's for the big one. This goes up.
The duck under and the collision with Disco Inferno. Oh, look at that. Right into Big Vito, and there's a DDT.
He's gone.
And two and three. Well, Disco played a role. Probably not the role that he expected, but nonetheless, the Mamalukes remain World Tag Team Champions.
Look at this.
Look at that, it's Crowbar and Daphne, almost as if they're laying in wait.
They're up to something.
Well, Lane and Idol get their tag title shot, but the belts remain with, well, look out, Disco!
Oh!
The lead pipe to the back, and look at that! Daphne's got the tag team gold!
Well, Daphne, Crowbar, and David Flair walked off with the World Tag Team Championships, but they are not the champions. The belt, or the championships, still remain with the Mamalukes. They got the belt back. Now, there's got to be a story there, Brain. The Mamalukes are again in possession of the World Tag Team Championship belt.
Well, I'm sure J.J. Dillon and the executive board from WCW is standing right back there when they went through that curtain and put a stop to this.
Look at that. The Paisans have their fans here on Saturday night. A little sip of Surge for Disco Inferno. Like, that guy needs more caffeine. Surge is a fantastic drink, but Disco doesn't need it. He's surging as we speak.
These guys take their time coming to the ring. They take advantage. They look over the whole area. They have eye contact with almost every fan. They make the opponents there in the back just wait. That's a smart move.
No, that is a smart move. I'm not going to dispute that. That's a good tag team. Johnny the Bull and Big Vito, up until recently, just the muscle for the Marinara family, now world tag team champions.
Well, they're better wrestlers than they are hired muscle. See, right. they make a few mistakes down the line here, and I don't think they mean to, but they mean well.
What's amazing to me is how quickly they have taken to the Disco Inferno and vice versa. They certainly were not seeing eye to eye the first time we saw the Mamalukes.
No, you're right about that, but I think they realize that they may need each other. They may need each other. They may need Disco Inferno to watch their back. Disco Inferno may need them so we don't have to swim in the river.
Wow. Probably wouldn't be doing much swimming, actually, if they put you in there. Whoa! Hang on.
Too much cement on his shoes.
Lane and Idol sending a message early. I think you can say some of those words on television. This match was supposed to go off Wednesday night on Thunder. Needless to say, the distraction of Ms. Hancock did not lend itself to coming up with a conclusion. So we're going to try it one more time. Oh, hang on, the Mamalukes jumping Lane and Idol. Tag team championships are at stake. Disco Inferno could not get that stipulation taken out of the contract. Idol, whoa, did he buy, I mean, a couple of double sledges right in the mush.
And you can tell the Mamalukes have worked out together a lot. Not only in the alleys, not only in a back room someplace, not only in an upstairs apartment. They know what to do. They have worked out together in the ring for this one thing, and that's to become tag team champions.
During the commercial break, we got, oh, hang on a second, Lane. From behind, Idol with a clothesline. Lane on top, lateral press, hook the near leg. He got a two count on Johnny the Bull. I was given some information regarding Monday night. Suffice to say, it's a good news, bad news situation.
Tell me.
First, the good news. We will find out for sure Monday night exactly what, hang on a second, Idol. No. What are these stipulations for the death match? Terry Funk and Ric Flair at Super Brawl. We've heard that it would be a death match, but we did not know the particulars. We will know the stipulations come Monday night. Wow! Lane with the high knee landed right in the chest of Johnny the Bull. Rolls him over, snap mare, lateral press, And Johnny the Bull rolled a shoulder.
And you know what's Monday night besides Nitro, don't you?
What's that?
It's Valentine's Day. We may see another St. Valentine's Day massacre on Nitro.
I bet we do in Uniondale, Long Island. Ric Flair and Hulk Hogan. The Tall Man! Spinning heel kick. Johnny the Bull wiped out Lane. Lateral press. Far leg hook. No, Lane.
No, get him. Wow. You know, we may see more red Monday night than we want to.
I agree. Flair and Hogan, the total package, and Terry Funk. We will hear the stipulations for Flair and Funk at Super Brawl in the death match. Now the bad news. Supposedly, the Cat has guaranteed James Brown, the godfather of soul, will be in Uniondale, Long Island, Monday night on Nitro. I'll believe it when I see it.
The hardest working man in show business. Papa's got a brand new bag himself. The Cat, Ernest Miller.
Let's see if the Cat can produce the Godfather of Soul Monday night. Spinning neckbreaker from Big Vito. Johnny the Bull now putting the boots to Lane.
If not, I know you can get a hold of Wilson Pickett.
I beg your pardon.
Never mind.
Pickett, I'll tell you. Snickers presents Super Brawl 2000. 1 week from tomorrow night. Oh, hang on a second. Double hip toss.
I never saw that before. I like that. I like that move.
You haven't seen that before?
Well, the other times they've used it, my horizontal visual dip went my therm went out on my motorator here.
Your what?
You wouldn't understand.
Wow! Diving lariat from Big Vito. Lateral press. Hooks the far leg. No, Lane rolled a shoulder. At Super Brawl 2000. Snickers, boy, I tell you, getting your money's worth. Sid Vicious will take on someone for the World Heavyweight Championship. Lane, roll up. No. It was scheduled to be Jeff Jarrett. Wow, standing sidekick. But now we don't know. Monday night, hopefully, Kevin Nash will clarify the situation. The commissioner returned last Wednesday on Thunder. Hopefully, Monday night, from Uniondale on Nitro, he will tell us who gets the shot at glory. Hang on a second. The Armstrong brothers, Scott and Steve Armstrong, walking out here on Saturday night. They're sending a message.
Another thing, notice all the beautiful girls that have been hanging around with Scott Hall and Kevin Nash. What do you think those beautiful girls are going to look like Monday night, St. Valentine's Day?
Oh, boy. I didn't think about that. What a great point.
So I've ever thought about.
Well, I guess so. Bobby the Brain Heenan stepping in, saving the day, yeah. What could the NWO girls, boy, that's right with possibility.
Hey, what a great present for your girlfriend. Candlelight, turn on Nitro.
Whoa, item with a two count, no.
Little spaghetti, little red sauce, and then call me. I'll be over in about a half hour.
I'm busy. Vito into the ropes, late and idle, ducked it.
Whoa, oh.
Steve Armstrong. Hang on a second, Steven Scott Armstrong. What on earth? They have jumped Lane and Idol. They just destroyed the up. Now wait a minute, Disco Inferno. Whoa!
They're not on anybody's side. They're on the Armstrong side, guys.
Scott and Steve Armstrong, out of nowhere, they jumped Lane and Idol. You'll remember last week when Lane and Idol interrupted the Armstrongs. Will turnabout is fair play.
Here we go again.
Well, this is definitely breaking down here on the Superstation. The World Tag Team Champions, Lane and Idol, Scott and Steve Armstrong. The champ has to get ready for David Flair and Crowbar at Super Brawl from Snickers 1 week from tomorrow night. Man, let's get some order restored here. We'll be back with Flair and